G'day, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. And if you're new here, as always, g'day and thanks for joining us for today's course playthrough. So today we have the 11th course for the TGC Tours Rookie Design Contest. Yes, I plan on doing them all. And today's course is Tecope Tatouche. Hope that's how you pronounce it. And this is designed by Pat Lowther. Alright, let's get into the settings. What do we got? Winds are default, the fairways are firm, the greens are firm, green speed is medium, the time of day is dusk, and the weather is overcast. And we will be playing from the tips, measuring 6,222 yards. That's on the black tees, that is, and on pin set one. Alright, that's enough of the business. Let's get out there and check out this great course for the rookie design contest and see how we score. Okay, here we are out on the course, and wow, what a beautiful time of day, because this first tee looks absolutely stunning off down there in the distance. Anyway, let's go back, pull up the camera, and go and have a look at this almighty, stunning looking sand dune type course. Wow, this looks absolutely insane. All right, let's just swing the camera around this way. We'll go and have a look at the clubhouse area. Just wander down this way, which looks pretty damn cool. Now I think this may be like a little bit of a practice green or something out here. Yes, it is. There you can see the little red flags. That always indicates a nice little practice green. But wow, look at this clubhouse. That looks pretty damn cool. If we can zoom up, got the old lighthouse up on top of it, or blended in with it. Wow, what a stunning looking course. Yeah, it's a nice little clubhouse area. You can see the road coming in to the clubhouse area, or to the course I should say. Nice little house up there. You got a house down this way as well. Very nice. All right, let's swing the camera up and around and get a bit more of a look of this course. Oh, there's another little house just down through there as well. Wow, what a stunning time of day. The sun really shines off all those sandy sort of top dune areas. Actually, I don't think it's sand, it's actually like dirt, but oh, just as good. And the planting that this design has gone for, absolutely stunning. Some of these sand bunker areas or waste areas are quite steep, so we don't want to go down into those, do we? But look at this, it plays all the way out right along the ocean's edge. Absolutely beautiful entry into this rookie design contest for this year. Absolutely stunning. I do love a good sand dune type course, and I expect I'm really going to enjoy playing this one. So let's just wander down towards the beach here. That's a beautiful looking little green area down through here. You got the shadows and just the sun showing off that green beautifully. Nice little bit of fence work behind there as well. We'll just swing the camera down and around this way just to get a shot of what it looks like along the coast. Wow, what a stunning job. Absolutely stunning work from this designer. Absolutely beautiful. Alright, well, I think we'll just wander down this way a little bit further. We'll just take in all the appreciation for all this planting that the designer has thrown into this. There is a lot of grass work and a lot of little bushes on this course. Absolutely magnificent. I really do like flying around and checking out the courses. To me, they're a work of art. They are. With all the planting, the routing, just the way everything looks and the way they get it to look in the lighting, and absolutely beautiful work of art, this one. All right, well, let's just get it back to the first tee and start swinging, because I'm quite eager to. Okay, hole one, par four. What do we got here? 478 yards, 35 feet down. Now okay. I think I might go the left-hand side of this. I think it's going to give us a better angle into the green. Put it about there. Oh, crushed it with a perfect as well. Wow, this course looks cool. Very cool. You've got all the undulations on the fairway, everything like that, all the, yeah, just the uneven surface. Okay, 144 remaining. Coming in with a 9. Oh, yeah, okay, we're going to bring it in with the 9. Actually, I might go the pitching wedge. Yeah, looking at that lie, where I am, I wonder if I can sneak it down this sort of right-hand side of the green and just sort of roll it back and around towards the hole here. That's what I'm kind of planning with this one. I'm going to give it a little bit of low loft just to give it a help, little bit of a helping hand to get there. Well, that could be, oh, that could be a little long. It is going to come back around though, just how I wanted it to. Okay, that's not too bad. Still pick up a par, a birdie here. Green speeds are 151, ooh. Okay. Quite a little downhill putt. Oh, that's turning. Wow, did that turn. Okay. We're going to start off with a par. Could be a challenging course today. Okay, let's keep going. Alright, what do we get here? Hole 2. Ooh, par 3. Hole in 1 chance. Beautiful little par 3 too. Alright, what do we got? 3-iron. That's 25 feet down. Bring that in with the 5, I think. Got under it beautifully. That wind is pushing slightly to the left. This might be... Oh, what a... That was a good distance. Alright, let's see if I can pick up a birdie on this putt. Nasty little bit of a break there at the end. Oh, wow, look at the turn on that. Oh, man, the greens are just like the fairways. Okay, here we go. Hole 3, par 4. Oh, again, giving us some options off this tee. Don't know if I want to go down here, though. I just don't want to go down that far in case I rip a nasty fast into it. So I'm going to play up here, put it about there. And I'm hoping that that wind is going to slightly bring it back around and kick it back onto the fairway. Oh, no, you dirty ball. Stayed in the rough. Okay, what do we got? 155, playing from the thick of it. Oh, do I bring it in with a 6? This is a hard one. I think I'm going to have to come in with a 6. Do have that win, though. Oh, massive red slow. That's not good. Beautiful bunker, though. Lob wedge splash. Oh, it's slightly downhill. Oh, come here, get in that hole. Get in the hole. In the hole. Oh, you're kidding. You're kidding me. That was so close to going in. Okay, 1 under after 3. Oh, no. Wife's hair, it's on me balls again. All right, anyway. Par 3. Only 1 chance. Hole 4. And again, another beautiful looking little par 3. This is a very nicely designed course. Okay, what do we got? 22 up. Let's bring that again. I think with the 5, we do have 5-mile winds coming against us here. Let's play straight at it. Oh, slight little fast. Is that going to kick back on the green? It does. Going a little higher than what I want. Oh, hang on, that's coming back. Oh, how much is this going to roll? Oh, no, I shouldn't have said anything. All right, downhill putt. Let's take some juice out. Nasty little break at our feet here. How much is that going to make it turn, though, as soon as we hit it? Ooh, slightly. Did turn. Are you going? Oh, no! Oh, no! I've under-hit it down the hill. This sort of slower green speed has just slowed it up. All right. Hole five, par five. 603 yards, 5 feet up. Wind's coming straight at us too. See, again, I hope everyone is enjoying all these rookie design courses. There are going to be quite a few on the channel, because I do like to cover this. I think I've done it 2 years running now. I think I said that last video, so yeah, it is absolutely stunning course in my opinion. It was the first contest that I ever covered, I'm pretty sure, when I first started, because I consider myself sort of like a rookie on YouTube. I still consider myself a rookie. I'm only a small channel. But yeah, so I thought, ah, it's fitting that I did the rookie design course, and I loved it, so I thought to myself, yep, from every year onwards, give these new designers a little bit of a playthrough and sort of let them check out someone else play their course to see how someone else would play it. It's always good to give the designer that. Yeah, and they're all unknown designers, which is awesome. Absolutely awesome, in my opinion. Yeah. All right, anyway, what do you got here? 80 yards remaining, 16 feet up. I shall stop rambling and hit the ball. Gap wedge pitch. I might take the pitching wedge pitch. Ooh, a bit of fast. Yeah, I felt that one. Absolutely ripped into it. Is that going to come back? No. Nasty little downhill slope. Got a little bit of a break to it. Don't want to take too much out because I might fall short again. Oh, that's going to turn at the end there. Oh, man, that must have just hovered straight over the edge of the hole. Our putting's a little off tonight. These are somewhat challenging greens. Well, just the way it breaks. And the green speed's throwing me for a loop. Used to the old 151s. Anyway, hole 6, par 4. Playing back towards the clubhouse. I think 6 mile wind's in our face. I think I might keep it on this side here. Yeah, grab that tee. We'll need that for the next one, mate. Okay, there, what has that left us with? 141 and 6 mile winds coming at us. Whoa, do I jump up to the 8 here? It is 10 feet up. I bring it in with the 8. Nasty light our feet as well. Tried to take a little bit out of that. 1%. 1%. That wind did hold it up a little bit, though. Again, a downhill putt. Not where I want to be. I want to be on the high side of it. Ooh, did I hit it too hard? Oh, again, it's just turned. It's just missed again. All right, let's go. Just riding the par train at the moment. Got the old one birdie. Okay, hole 7, par 4. Yep, straight down the middle. No practice swing. Rushed it. Feels weird when I don't do my little practice backswing. I've got so much into a habit of doing it. Oh, that's right. Just hold that fairway, baby. Okay, 136. Again, 6 miles going with us. Pitching wedge. Ooh, gap wedge. Downhill slow. I'll bring it in with the gap wedge. Oh, that is really going out to the right-hand side. Just needs to roll. I don't think it's going to get the slope. That wind pushed me a lot more than what I wanted there. Again, downhill putt. Was it going to come back? Oh my god. Oh man. How many of those have I had? I've had like three putts where it's just skimmed the edge. Oh, you lucky ball. See the turn on that one then. Just at the end of that. Oh, all right, hole 8, par 4. Absolutely brilliant looking course. This is playing very, very nicely. Wouldn't be surprised if this gets on tour. Oh, that could be heading towards that bunker in the middle. Depending on which way it's going to kick me here. Oh, just up and around the top of it. Oh, look at the lie we're going to have here. Look how steep that is. A little lob wedge normal. Let's take some juice out of it. Let's see what we can do. Oh, 88%. Look at the turn on that. Oh, I was on the money with the distance. All right, wow. Finally pulled out another birdie. 2 under after 8. Wow. Okay, hole 9, par 5. What do we got here? 535, 8 up. 5 miles coming at us. A bad drive. What kind of lie is that going to give us again? Ooh. Yeah, I don't think you're really going to get a flat line on these fairways, which is nice. Nice challenge. All right, coming in with the hybrid. Oh, can we run it around here? Oh, the elevation, though, I might even reach the green here. Will I? Was it going to roll out onto the green? Is it just going to get on? Oh, it's just got on, but that is going to be one hell of a nasty putt. There was a lot of red up here. Oh, look at this. Look at that downhill slope, too. All right, let's pull some out of that. Let's bring that way over this way. There's the hole. Might even leave the pin in this one. Oh, wow, this is going to turn. Alright, this looks insane, this putt. Here we go. I think around about here somewhere. Oh, it's not a bad putt, I guess, for the amount of break that thing had and the roll. Look at that, I just tapped it. Right, straight putt. Please be straight. Say that. Get rid of that pin now. Oh, was that my swing line that did that? It slightly, ever so slightly veered off to the left. Could have been my swing, I think, I think it was. All right, hole 10. Well, we got 317, 20 up. Coming in with the driver. We're not going to get that far, though. Do that red far, or not a red fast, but that fast, which way is it? It's going to kick me in the bunker, isn't it? Oh, you bastard. A pitching wedge splash. Ooh. Is that the 9-iron splash? How much is this going to roll? It's not often I do a 9-iron splash, so let's give it a go. Have a nasty turn, nasty kick out of the bunker here. Okay, 9-iron splash. That worked out quite nicely. Putt didn't go so nicely though, did it? Wow, the turn. These green speeds are challenging. So used to everything being fast these days. Especially when you're playing on tour, it's always like I call it the three F's, firm and fucking fast all the time. When you're playing on playing your rounds for the week. Okay, let's put that one straight down the middle. Oh, is that going to sit up, stay up here, stay up top. Oh, it is just, oh, no, nah, shit, look at that, it's gone. Bloody hell. All right, 124. Let's bring that back to the old gap wedge. We could probably even play the sand wedge into this. From that downhill run. No, we'll go the gap wedge. My lie. Nasty. That's what it is. Not too bad. Again, another downhill putt. Gonna turn. There it is. There's a nice little break. Puts it right in the center of the cup. Alright, 4 under after 11. Hopefully this back 9's a bit more generous to me. Okay, hole 12, par 4, 372, 23 feet down. With that wind again. Designer's given us options here. I do like. I was praying for a perfect on that one. Might be able to just run right up in front of the green. Just like that. Okay, lob wedge pitch. Oh, that's probably a bit drastic, seeing that it's all downhill. It's a lie. Okay. Oh wow. Funny, you know. Sometimes you got to take a little bit out, and you think, okay, oh, it's still rolling, which isn't too bad, but. You got to take a little bit out, and other times you take that little bit out and you end up belting it over the hole anyway, but man, sometimes it just takes a heap out of it. It's one of those things I just find it very hard to judge. Especially with a partial shot, I always find them difficult. Okay, hole 13, ooh, hole in one chance, and we have the hybrid in the hand. That's got to be, what, at least 200 yards, 240. 233. Oh, actually, hang on. 43 down. Let's knock that back to a 3-iron. Play the 3. Yeah, I think we'll stick with the 3-iron here. Look at that wind. Might work out to kick that way. Now I want to catch this slope. I want to see if it comes back towards the hole. That's what I was kind of hoping for on that one. Was it going to find? No. Yes, it is. Oh. What a cliffhanger. I didn't think it was going. Alright, 6 under now. We're sort of cruising. Shouldn't have said anything. That'll probably jinx me. Okay, hole 14. Hole in one chance. I'd love to get a hole in one right now. That would work. That'd be so nice. What do we got? 155. 1 foot up. 4 miles coming at us. Coming in with the 8-iron. Might not be bad. I think it's going to leave me a little short. Wind is moving around a little bit. Oh, that was beautiful, actually. A little short. What was I thinking? I just seen that uphill slope in front of it when we were on the tee there. I'm like, if it hits that, I'm stuffed. Oh, thank you. Thank you, ball. Alright, 7 under. Not so bad. Now we're cruising, like I said before. Alright, hole 15, par 5. Let's see if we can shoot it straight up here. Oh, slight little slow. Kind of glad I aimed out to the left there. Let's get down the bottom of this hill. Might be able to use the driver here off the deck. Our distance. Well, you know what? I think I might come in with the driver here. It's going to come in hot. Put some low loft on it, see if we keep it low. Take a little bit of distance out. What are we aiming for? Rightio. Slope just at the back here. That could push me fair way down to the right. Oh, that's going to leave me with one hell of a putt. Okay. But we're putting for eagle. I do not mind. So there's the pin, the hole. Got the pin in it for you. Makes it a little bit hard to see. Okay, uphill. We're going to hit this. I might take a smidgen of power out of this. Always the slow green speeds. You always tend to belt it. See what I mean? Wasn't bad power. Wasn't bad power on that one. Okay, not too bad. Alright. Well, this could be the complete opposite to the front nine. Okay, hole 16. Par 3. Oh, this is a nice little par 3. Alright, so we want to catch this slope here and just trickle it down. Probably even land it maybe up here and sort of run it down towards the hole as well. 6 irons, 25 feet down. 160. Oh, I don't think you could do it with the 8. Maybe? Not with that wind, though. Take the 7. Oh, no. Oh, that wind held me up, didn't it? Oh, I was like, oh, yeah, that's on. Catch the slope. This should be good. That turned out shit. All right, 19 yards. Lob wedge splash. Let's kick it out of this bunker. Oh, hang on, what was that? There was something up there. That swing felt quite laggy for some reason. Oh no, par threes, man, they're a killer. Absolute killer. Oh, made it though. What a putt. Judged it nicely. All right, two holes remaining. Here we go. 17th. Second last. Oh, right along the coast. Oh, that wind's pushing me out there. I'm going this side. Going way up here. Oh, hang on, hang on. Whoa, whoa, whoa. We got a hybrid. Oh, okay. So I see why. You know what? I'm going the driver. Stuff it. I'm going to put it off the back. I'll chip on. Or something like that. I'm happy to do that. Oh, it's going to hold the fairway, is it? Oh, just. Okay. Little lob wedge pitch. That's probably going to go further than what I think. Always does. Then again, I've taken so much out, it'll probably go shorter. Nope. There you go, see? Look at that. 78% on that. Look how far that went. Okay, a little uphill putt. 2 inches up. Oh, almost. Ooh, my putt line, my swing line, sorry, could have contributed to that break then. Okay, remaining 8 under. What can I do on this last hole? All right, hole 18, par 5. Let's send it right up here on the hill. We caught it slow, so that's going right up. Come on, give me a nice kick. Yeah, that's kicking on, surely. Yep. Nice big par 5 to finish off the round. I like it. Yep, driver. Let's bring that in. And might put a little bit of low loft on it. What's the slopes look like up there? Okay, yep. Don't know if you caught that, but I did. Yep, caught it. Definitely. Right to the bunker. Well, that doesn't feel right. I need to add more to that. Feels a little bit better. Oh, the backspin that had on it. All right, and we put it away for a birdie. So yeah, 9 under after that round. Wow, what a stunning course. That was very, very enjoyable to play. Very enjoyable. Quite challenging in areas too, especially if you didn't nail your shot right. So again, that was our 11th course for the TGC Tours Rookie Design Contest. And that one is Tecope Tatouche. And that was designed by Pat Lowther. So yeah, very nice course, dude. Look at it, it's got 3.4k plays already. 4.5 stars. Damn right it does. Damn right. Anyway, that's me done. So I'll catch you again next time soon with another rookie design course. We're going to get through them all. But yeah, be patient. And if you do like this, I'm glad. Anyway, I'll catch you all again next time. See ya.